Hi, it's Jake, and today I listen to Young Genius by Lil Mabu. And, this project, it's pretty bad. Consider this your disclaimer now. If you enjoyed this project and you don't want to hear someone criticizing it, click away. Click a different video, watch anything else. But if you want to just kind of get an idea for what this project has to offer and listen along with me, stick around.
Hello, hello.
Good morning. It's Jake. You see what's in front of us. I have a buddy who would certainly love if I listened to this project, despite me not really wanting to listen to it. Yeah, it's the new Lil Mabu project. I hold reservation calling it new because like 7 of these songs are just over a year old at this point, or about to be a year old. But you know, in the good year of our Lord 2024, what better than a Lil Mabu project? So let's get started with the first track, Pledge.
Okay.
You can really kind of hear some of the recycling coming through already on the first track. I mean, I've heard him here say Dolly like, what, 20 times now?
Look, you could be a lawyer or a doctor.
I picked a different road. I'm a rap guy, put the goons by my side. I'm in the middle road. Sorry, mama, got a bigger goal. Need a candy rose like a Mr. Malone. Whole world gonna be singing my songs and I'll do it myself because I'm better alone.
Shot him in the chest and now he doing the pledge. I could have lined him up, I'd rather do it instead. Because I don't trust the soul. Half these bitches be feds. I put trust to build my Glock and all the bullets is fed. I put trust to build my Glock to make sure everything dead. I'm the demon laying under your bed.
Where the money at?
Life's like a panini, you can flip it in bed. You can twist it, turn it, and burn it, but first comes the bread.
Where the money at?
So first song, Pledge, it's got a pretty cool instrumental. It's really heavy. It's smacking you in the face after like 30 seconds. I suppose the line about, you know, hitting him in the chest make him do the pledge is kind of cool, but look, this isn't going to be the most nuanced take here, but when it comes to terms of believability, I have absolutely zero when Lil Mabu's saying it, and I feel like I relate with a majority of people on that one. No one believes this bullshit. Okay, for the next track, Mathematical Disrespect, we have the lovely pleasure of watching a video along with it. Let's get into it. 3.14159. He's gonna talk about pi.
Private school. They saying his dad run a label.
Nah, I think he's just mad smart.
I don't know, gang. I'm jacking out here industry plant, bro. One kid doing all this. Ain't no way. Facts.
How much you think he paid him to say all this?
I think he's a young genius.
Like, most of our rappers are signed to the streets. Only dealers we took was a plea. Mabu your money, Wally P, shout out my label, that's me. I own 100% of my cuts, bitch, nobody taking a fee. 3.14159265 3. I'm the king of NYC. I heard they send my music to police, so this is a message to MIPD.
You know who he reminds me of? He reminds me of the kid who stepped on the fish in New York City, calling himself the king. Yeah, that's a very fair fit to me, I think.
Cap on my raps, I'm an innocent tweet. Keep a titty bet when I sleep. I'm rapping the words, but they write it for me. Me, I'm all about keeping the peace. I mean, at least I get paid, because a lot of these rappers be capping for free. They call me the op, I got the bread she chopped, but said, can I bring a friend? Never, never, never. I guess she forgot the bev, like 2 5s don't equal it.
Why not? Yeah, at this point, why not? Just go get the fucking TikTok guy in here and fuck it, do Fortnite as well. I will commend him. At least, like, he's making it entertaining to watch, but, like, it is a spectacle. This is a joke to witness. This isn't something impressive.
10. Quick math, don't try it again. She shaped like a turtle or a hen. Her makeup is fucked, she don't know how to bend. Make her do Wordle.
Get it, because blue and red equals purple. So I blew her back out when I left her all red. Don't let that go over.
Clever. One thought, two thought, three thought. He's smart.
They all put their knees on the floor. Keisha, Becky, Sophie, Zoe.
I invested money in myself and it paid. I can't take a break till my boo is a household name.
Yeah, you could certainly be a little bit more edgy and offensive. That song's not the worst. I'm not going to sit here and pretend that it is, but that singing at the end was not the best either. When are we going to see this guy do a chorus, though? If he can do a chorus, I might consider being impressed. Next song is Underdog Song. It's got Little Baby. Let's see.
I don't forgive and forget. Bitch, I remember and hate. This the Underdog Song. Who can relate? When I die, pull up, don't be late.
So yeah, that singing is not good.
To my grave and let me down one last time. It's fine, you could let me down one last time. One last time.
Yeah, baby, see everything. I just ain't blind. It's your time to die.
If you ran like your mouth, you'd be in good shape. Every time you clap, tighten up your shoulders. You like a...
Why am I giving points to this? Yeah, ran your mouth, you'd be in good shape. Sure, it's a fine bar. Why not?
At BBL, you don't make shit shake on the gram, telling people
it's my time, just wait.
We've been locked in for show, that's my little no-name. You let me down before, I can't keep playing those games, you can't get...
It's a different type of track, you don't see the end. I'ma keep on shooting at the side till we meet again. Get big flexing.
Alright, don't confuse what I'm about to say here. The aggression here, this little flow in the way he came in, it certainly caught me off guard and it's a nice change of pace, but I'm not quite hearing anything of substance in there.
I pull up, don't be late, so you can lower me into my grave and let me down.
This is a different type of track, you don't see the end. I'ma keep on shooting at the sky till we meet again. Get big flexing, my last bitch was an anorexic. She was sick in the head,
yeah.
Put in the bed.
He ain't saying shit in there. He's telling you that his last bitch was anorexic. Congratulations. Overall, we've got like 30 seconds to go to this song. I think he got one of the more lazy little baby verses. The beat's not the worst thing in the world, but similar to the kind of energy I was feeling on the first song, like, just because the beat's good, you gotta add something of substance there. And I mean, the singing is terrible. And if there is a chorus in here, it's certainly not something standout.
Cause Mabu the hottest kid, I know the bait. So look at my skin and feel that type of weight. I ain't really wanna rap, then I saw Maybach. Got my tape in June, but I brought Maybach. Yeah, baby got a Maybach. We drive by school and the bitches been back. I was in class making raps, they laugh. Swear to God, getting rich is the best payback.
One last time,
it's fine.
You could let me down one last time. You could let me down one last time. You could let me down one last time. One last time.
Lil Baby really didn't even need to be on that song. Next song, Throw. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I've kind of got a bad feeling about this song because it looks like we're gonna be getting into our singy-songy bag, and that is not Mabu's strong suit by any means. I ain't saying he's overly impressive when he is rapping, but I'd prefer he just stick to that rather than doing the singing stuff right now. So, fingers crossed. Let's give him a chance.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. They had a special place in my heart, so I tried fixing them without breaking me. I learned the hard way, but I do it no more, thankfully. Turned to a beast when I thought I saw them way to see. I wasn't supposed to make it this far, I'm talking racially. This shit feels make-believe. I was slow, naughty, wouldn't stay with me in the streets. I ain't never paused to V, and I've been on the charts for weeks. I had a vision, no one seen, not even my family. Music is saving me, but I know it could end fatally. So I keep that 40 on my side, ain't no one taming me. I wasn't perfect as a kid, but I still ate my greens. I started working in the crib when my friends were smoking weed.
I hate to stop it here, but I have a little bit of an internal conflict here with this artist in general, with thinking, you know, it's all just a joke, right? Like, this is all just one giant joke. They're doing it for fun. They're making light of New York drill, all that kind of stuff. But it's just a, you know, they don't take themselves that seriously, right? I don't know about that anymore, because as I sit here and I look at an album, a full release from a label with title Young Genius, 17 songs, big name features, and taking some songs that are seemingly stabs at a little bit tougher subject matter, I do think he takes himself seriously. And since Lil Mabu seems to take his music seriously, I therefore have to listen to it with a serious ear. But the problem is, I can only hear it in this funny context. It sounds like a joke because, honestly, the music is a joke.
Doing good and got more enemies. I keep my face up out the net when I be in the streets. I know my boys got my back, but when it comes to torn straps, hope they don't rhyme when the bullets get ahead of me.
Yeah, I don't think I could have timed my little segment there any better, because it seemed like he was approaching some sentimental subject matter, getting in a little bit more of a feels type bag. Oh, but no, we're just gonna shift it right out to hard drill again. It doesn't have any sense of pacing whatsoever. This project is just a playlist. You don't have to like that, but this project is not a album. It's just a bunch of songs in a playlist. Deal with it. I have a question. Are people really looking for Mabu out there in New York like that? I don't mean, like, do people listen to his music? I mean, are they out there listening to it on the streets in their cars when they drive by? Are people actually bumping this stuff, or is it just cute to them? For reference, I've only ever once heard someone drive past me in a car playing Lil Mabu, and they were very clearly 16. That's why I ask. Yeah, final thoughts on Throw. It's not anything super offensive or anything like that, but it's just unimpressive. That's really what I'm getting from everything so far. It's just super unimpressive. I'm not going to sit here and say it's the worst thing in the world, but I have no reason to return to this again. Next song is Me Vs. Me.
My friend told me pop a bean. He started counting down from three. I ain't taking that shit, told him leave. But the devil with me saying please. He took a perk and rolled up his sleeve. Popped the cap with some liquor codeine. Took my cup, started pouring a bean. Should I rap or get a degree?
I don't know.
I feel like it's me versus me.
I guess it's gonna be what it be.
I hope I don't end up a fiend. Tripping on beans and seeing in 3D.
I hope money start growing on trees.
Call up my mama and say I'm on TV. Should I hang out with Tim or Luis? Should I call up James or Marquise? Student by day, I'm a demon at night. It's cut and a Glock got a big red light. And I'm looking for the ops on site.
Yeah, I'm struggling here. I am certainly struggling here. That whole line about student by day, demon by night, I just don't want to fucking hear it anymore. We know you're not actually a demon in the nighttime, so I just really don't want to fucking listen to it. Let's keep going.
Got your hit, little bitch, I'm lucky. Once I go back to the crib to read, gotta study for 5 APs.
Yeah, I'm usually locked in, putting in pain. Voice in my head, screaming my name. There are too many things in my brain.
Like what?
Money, bitches, fame. One day sunny, next day it rains. And Omichi, he doing cocaine. I'm with the white kids, then the gang. It's like one day I'm gay, then I'm straight.
I feel like it's me versus me.
Wait, did I just miss something there? Hold up.
Gang, kids, then the gang. It's like one day I'm gay, then I'm straight.
I feel like it's me versus me.
I guess it's gonna be with it.
What did he just say there?
And Omichi, he doing cocaine. I'm with the white kids, then the gang. It's like one day I'm gay, then I'm straight.
I have to be misinterpreting that. Someone please correct me on what he's saying there. I'm not looking up the lyrics right now.
Feel like it's me versus me.
I guess it's gonna be with it be.
I hope I don't end up a fiend. Tripping on beans and seeing in 3D.
I hope money start growing on trees.
Call up my mama and say
I don't have the biggest of worries that Mabu is gonna end up like a fiend. I think he's pretty well taken care of, everything considered. So why are you even fucking saying it? I don't think he's concerned whether he's going to turn out to be a fiend. And that's kind of what I'm getting at here, is all of this just sounds like a bunch of bullshit. He's saying it because it sounds good, which makes it corny and a gimmick and really hard to listen to.
Should I hang out with Tim or Luis? Should I call up James or Marquise? Student by day, I'm a demon at night. And a Glock got a big red light. And I'm looking for the ops on site. Catch a hit, little bitch, I'm might say go back to the crib to read. Gotta study for 5 APs. But I'd rather be in the streets. See a kid got a mark with a bean.
Yeah, the dude's smart too. He's in 5 AP classes. What are you doing on the streets? Just go to school, get a degree, be smart. What the fuck? You know, the worst part about this is I'm pretty sure, I'm confident enough to say this, anybody who is actually out in the streets would be telling him, stay the fuck out of the streets! Go to school! If you have access to school, go get your fucking degree and get a real job. And I don't say that to talk down on people who are living real lives out there. I'm saying it more as, you were born with privilege, acknowledge it and don't abuse it, because that's clearly what he's doing right now. The only reason he can get away with saying half of this stuff is because he comes from money. You know, at a certain point, it starts to get insensitive, and I think this is about where I started feeling that way with Mabu's music. Next song is Trip to the Hood. Yeah, this isn't playing the hood for a spectacle at all. This is just good cinematography. Let's get into it.
Gee whiz. Trip to the Hood.
Howie? Mav?
Yo, Mabu, let's go take a trip to the hood, gang. Yo.
That sounds radical, bro.
Radical. Goodbye, father. I am going out to hang with my friends and do academic activities.
Okay, father. I'm darting off to pursue my educational prowess.
My educational prowess.
Son, don't dilly-dally. I'll be home late. It's my bridge night.
I'll see you later. Bye.
Bye.
Took a trip to the hood so I could make it out. Just so y'all can say I got shit handed down. I did it totally, no one puts it in my bank account.
Except when they did.
If you don't know me,
then shut your
mouth. What goes around comes around like an echo sound. Karma's a bitch, I guess you know it now. Said I could never snitch and made 300,000. And I got goons by my side, so come around.
Honestly, the dad seems like the chillest guy here. If there's anybody I'd love to have a chat with, it's just the dad, and ask him, why are you letting your son do this? Do you really like this? Do you think this is a smart decision for his future? I mean, maybe it is, because he's probably making a fuckload of money right now. What do I know?
And bitch, I'm tough by myself. Yo, you over there, come on. Y'all so internet goons, get up off your couch. Bitches be crazy while I have my baby, gotta wait it out. I'm 17, but all these ladies wanna hit it. Bitch, I woke up this morning on some different shit.
Bong.
The only hoe I need is a whole lot of green in the money brick.
So yeah, the bell's cool, but we know who did it first. You ain't even got to say the name.
Cause when I stood up from behind, all the gangsters buckle in.
Hey, yo, that's Mabu, yo?
Yo, that's Mabu.
Not so fast, not so fast. Give me the keys, give me the keys.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, probably.
What you mean?
Could never stitch and make 300,000. And I got two on my side, so come around.
Who the fuck is that?
Oh, look at that. You did Dilly Dally, didn't you? Yeah, I ain't even gonna hold back on that one. That beat goes illegally too hard. I mean, that is a fucking insane beat, and it's got the bell. But this song is a fucking zero. This song is terrible. If it is not making light of a situation and playing it for spectacle, then I don't know what the fuck is. It's right in front of your face. If you like it, more power to you. I can't stand to watch this bullshit. It's corny. We return to Spotify for the 7th track, Like a Cop. Yeah.
I'm like a cop.
You ain't like one. You might as well be one.
I'm like a cop. Where I not keep it by my side like a fly.
Look, another side rant here, but since he's kind of talking about being a cop, you know, a lot of the shit he's doing, although very unlikely, I wouldn't be surprised if given enough time, something could come from him putting his friends out there like this. And I'm using the word friends loosely, but the people he associates with, I wouldn't be surprised if, you know, years down the road, he is part of the reason or a contributing reason to why people get locked up. Just remember that.
Wherever I reside, but it's fine, cause I know a guy, he piggy buddy slime.
Shit was feeling off, just me and Rashad look up to God. Please have mercy on me, I got school tomorrow, I threw my grip in the fucking car.
Look, I said that kind of rant previously because, again, I don't think half the stories he's talking about are actually real or they're extremely exaggerated, but if one of them turns out to be real and they ever decide to go back to his music and say, hey, look at that, you just snitched fucking playing out right here, we're gonna use this against you, it could look bad, you know?
They got some turbans pulling up and shit, I dropped my fucking jaw, they popped the squad, told me turn around, do what I say, the pig squealing.
Got a grown man feeling on me, that shit kinda... Anyway,
they asked for my ID, I said I'm 17, that's when his own ass realized he kind of molested.
Anyway, he's from New York, someone's gotta pause that on him. Someone's gotta say, pause, bro, pause, what the fuck?
Me, but I was slick, cause I had a fake ID and he's swatting shit wherever I reside, but it's fine, cause I know a guy, he piggy buddy slum. You'll never catch me doing time. They ain't found
he
the
said
knocks
it.
In the Vito. You know that I dodged the fucking Rico.
He's the one who said it. He called himself a cop. I didn't say it. That was him. All right. This is a good enough point for me to go grab a snack real quick. Otherwise, my brain's probably going to fry listening to the 10 remaining tracks. I'll be back briefly, and then we'll get into the rest of this. Someone should probably pause that over here with a big banana. Sussy Baka. Next song here isn't even a fucking full song. It's literally just his On the Radar freestyle. He just threw it on the album. Let's get into it.
Gang, gang, gang.
Hey, man.
I'm not a cop. I'm not a cop.
You just said you were!
Mabu.
Yeah, I woke up this morning and put on my fit on some typical white boy shit. Khakis and white socks, black kicks. I ain't sleeping 1400 minutes.
Got a rollie on my left. I got friends that'll switch. I'm just waiting till they step. I got a tech in a tech. So don't make me upset. You're just losing money in the street. Dice cards, you can't better yourself.
I'm mad.
married to the game, only hunters on my God. They like Mabu, you capping your rap.
Ah. You know, despite the singing sounding very flat and just kind of monotone, it was better than some of the previous singing we've been hearing on this project. Surprisingly, I was kind of ready to jump on this one for just throwing the on-the-radar freestyle, but this might be the most impressive performance so far. Congratulations, Mabu.
How you know what I did? Stop doing the teasing, I'm dealing out poop keys. I really rap what I did.
If he kept my ass,
I load up his balance and switch out his sim. Yes, I know I'm a kid. Yes, but tell me I'm capping, I'm popping your lid. 3.14159265. Guns be ready to die. I just bodied a beat while
now there's the pie.
Your life is a lie. Try to set me up on a hit with a chick. I'm cutting that line.
I knew there was the fucking pie line somewhere. I really thought it was going to be on mathematical disrespect given the title, but I guess it was on this one. Yeah, no real different from the large majority of everything else we're hearing here. It just felt a little bit... This performance just felt a little tighter, I guess, is my words for it. So it gets a little bit more of a pass from me, but I don't consider me enthused yet. Strap in, kids, because it's time we revisit school. Babu's going to teach us how to drill.
Now let me tell you what's been going on. It's been a lot of...
Oh my God, it's Professor.
A lot of people dissing.
He went off the grid.
A lot of dead folks around. This is drill 101. What you gotta do is take these guns, kill, draw, porno, fire.
Consider me a little bit Smekeldorf right now, but I might have had an epiphany. Maybe this is just all one giant social commentary. And Mabu is just kind of painting the reality for what it is with white suburban kids listening to hip hop music. And I preface this with, I'm a white suburban kid. I'm not a kid anymore, but I was a white suburban kid who did all the same shit. And the cycle repeats itself. At some point, though, we do have to put our foot down and say no. And I would highly doubt that this is all just one giant social commentary. Still lean on the side of thinking that this is Mabu playing light with the whole white boy in rap situation. But, you know, he's playing the part well, so it makes me question it even at that.
I'm not fucking filling this class. What comes after gra gra? Oh. What comes after gra gra?
Boom.
Gra gra, boom. It's gra gra, boom, my boo. What the
boom? You know, I don't want to hear you. I don't want to hear you.
Pointing at a pencil at someone with a gun.
Let's go, y'all have a good day.
That's kind of funny.
Everybody needs to be back at the mall, fuck the mom, and have mom kill. It's my point.
Yeah, nigga. Oh no. I remember what song this is. I already know what we're gonna get to see. Okay.
And don't tell nobody what you do when you do finish what you're doing, nigga. Kripow! It's a movie. Firewood. Bow! Yeah. Pull up, let me show you around this place. See them little niggas on that gate?
Should I punch him in his face?
Chill, little bro, you gotta wait.
Then he better look the other way before I put him on a chase.
Damn, it's little white boy Lace. He about to make us catch another case. You don't wanna be in no jailhouse, you don't wanna be with no jakes. Watch what I do, listen what I say, copy my moves, follow my pace. Gotta take notes what's around you so you never make mistakes.
My fault, Favi, I'm new to this place.
Yeah.
It's weird because I'm partly kind of just ashamed that Favio would even take part in something like this, but the part he is adding to it isn't the most offensive thing in the world. I mean, it is like a teacher kind of guiding you through your situation, but you kind of have that responsibility of saying, like, no it sometimes. Like, you don't belong here, and I feel like the people around Mabu should have said, yeah, you're kind of crossing a line, buddy, especially with what's about to come up next.
Welcome to the hood.
If you with us, you good.
Yeah, Fitchy, wooed up.
Backpacks full of rulers.
Yeah, I got a white shooter.
Let me pop his perk so I can focus up. Look at demon outside with me at night. They gon' know who did it when I face white. Yo, Five is packing the trigger. White boy, what you my nigga?
You already know, I'm not gonna say it.
If you play with his pops, you a victim.
I walk in any hood, I'm good. Cause I'm with the thugs that'll take him.
Welcome to the hood. He look like a singer, but white boy, get up on him. You can't say the word, I'ma say it for him.
You're not the biggest, I'm bigger. You just a broke little
nigga.
Alright, all I want to know behind that bar, really, is who came up with it. If Fiveo came up with it, more power to him. Do what you want to do, but I feel like Mabu not only came up with it, but he thought it was the most clever thing in the world when he came up with it. That's all I'm going to say. I'm not going to hang us up there. Let's keep it moving.
And I'm young, and I'm richer. Five bands on a fit.
If you with us, you good.
Yeah,
50. Wooed up. Backpacks full of rulers. Yeah, I got a white shooter. And no, I ain't shooting no schools up. Yeah, I feel like the drill tutor.
Can I do a hit on a scooter?
How many fucking times you gonna ask to do a hit on a scooter? That was a one-time thing. The gang don't fuck with that dumbass buffoonery.
Please.
Slide through, don't let the ops find you. Keep your eyes behind you.
I feel like the drill tool to blade.
Can I do a hit on a scooter?
Wow. Yeah, that instrumental do be kind of insane, though.
After that drill, you come home, eat that meal. Throw that gun away, take the gloves off, and don't bring them back to home, nigga.
And the horns and everything in there, too. And don't tell nobody who told you how to go on a drill, nigga.
Go! Organized crime.
Wow. You did that, huh? I feel like I brought my Italian roots back.
Of course he's Italian. Yeah, I feel very similar to that song as I did on the intro track. The beat was illegally hard. It was a really, really good beat, but I'm somewhere in between with whoever came up with a large majority of the subject matter is going to really decide where I put this one. I'm going to assume it was Mabu who came up with this, like, came up with this whole track. Decided, let me get 504 on here. Let me have him say the word I can't say. And because of that alone, I feel like this song is a fat zero. It's absolute dog shit. All right, we're at least taking a step in the right direction, and we're over halfway. Next song is Evil Empire. Let's get it.
Put the chill on my jack. Beam to his back. Say hello to my cat. Mabu, Mr. Move Tack, boom with your ass, leave a bullet in fries.
Ayo, Mabu, don't fall.
I told Ted I start feeling alive.
Yeah, I'm a star, clutching on this nine.
Didi better pull out when I ride.
You know I'm a slide, little Didi arrive. Trying to shoot a nigga in his eye.
Pull up on me, let's have a good time. I'm sliding the back of my head, I got eyes.
Ayo, Mabu, who's that? Fuck it, don't shot at his back. Up it, just need my guy. He think I put in the back.
And when the smoke fly high, it goes to heaven, not hell. So the ops breathing and getting high, not knowing they smoking themselves. Mabu go cool with the deuce. I think the screws on my head a little loose. Like, pass the cane, put a beam on a broom. Bitch, when I up and shaka like a boom. Like, I be acting a fool. Like,
I get tired of the random poop bar or just poop reference every now and again, or farting references now and again. It gets tiresome, let me tell you that.
Mabu, my left, I steal my right. He like Diddy, I know.
What the fuck? I was thinking in my head, fucking skididdy pop pop, and the thing go through the fucking Big Shaq shit, and he literally did it. I predicted the thing. This song is so fucking weird.
Like I'm first one I see, he gets hurt to a pack. I'm like, get the fuck back, cause when I start clicking, I forget I rap. Put the chill on my jack, beam to his back, say hello to my cat. When I start clicking, I forget I rap. Get back. Put the chill on my jack, beam to his back, say hello to my cat. Mabu, Mr. Move Tack, boom with your ass, leave a bullet in trash.
I'm sorry, at this point, I don't give a fuck anymore. Dude, Mabu really wants to be fucking black. He keeps making references to getting a black card and not being able to say a certain fucking line or a certain word. It's tiresome. Get over yourself, for fuck's sake. Yeah, this song felt like a fucking giant recycling plant. It felt like all the sounds that they couldn't fit anywhere else on this project. They stuck a fucking fart noise, a bitch getting railed, and Mabu speaking absolute fucking gibberish on this song. This song's terrible. Get the fuck out of here. I almost forgot. We have a video for this one, and how could I forget? Next song is Mr. Take Ya Bitch with Christian Rock. Oh joy. I feel like the internet also went fucking crazy when he did this thing, as if it was something super impressive. Like, before he did this, everybody was making fun of Blueface and Christian. They were the relationship to make fun of. I don't suppose that it was that hard to swoop in and do this. And I think he also knows the position he's in where Blueface isn't going to do anything to him. So it's just, it's kind of spineless. That's how it comes off.
Like, I'm Mr. Take your bitch, take her for a trip.
Christian, if anything, probably needs help more than anything. And you're just kind of platforming her to push this spiral even further. I don't know. It seems to me like making a spectacle out of someone who's suffering. Maybe they're actually friends, you know, but we don't get to see all that behind the scenes stuff. It seems like a gimmick to me. Fly to New York, sign my name all on the tits. Yes, I took his lady. I like blue faces, so I took his baby. Fuck blue face, I had a fun in him. Yeah, I with my bone, fuck shit. You say, I'm well, that's not so well, fine. This a new bone, pussy, make my water break. Gross! Can we agree that that line is fucking gross? The only thing that's broke is my fucking water. Gave birth to my kid, but I hate his father. I used to fuck with blues, now I fuck with ones. Only fuck with white boys, that means I'm Mr. Take your bitch. Take her for a trip. Fly her to New York. Sign my name all on her tits. Can we also acknowledge the fact that this song has children doing the dance on the internet? That's not a good thing. Yes, I took his lady. I like blue faces, so I took his babies. And no, that's not a diss. But I know Whack 100 ain't gon' like this. Cause he fuck with snitches and I don't like kids. And he probably racist and don't like white kids. Hit him in the face with a drink. Not that I don't appreciate the sentiment of him calling out, you know, 6ix9ine or something like that, but it just feels weird coming from Mabu. Not like I'm not trying to say that Mabu is in any bit of a similar situation to 6ix9ine, but they are both corny as fuck. It kind of comes off as a clown calling a mime funny looking to me. Show him I take money to the grave, no breather. Crody six deep, now I'm six deep in his chick. I might take your whole. You know, actually switch that. It sounds like a mime making fun of a clown to me, because if anything, Mabu is just doing exactly what 6ix9ine did years before. And take your bitch. Wow! Mister, take your bitch. Take her for a trip. Fly her to New York. Sign my name all on her tits. Yes, I took his lady. I like blue faces, so I took his baby. That doll is fucking creepy. I don't like that. Yeah, no. That's gonna be a no from me, dog. Six tracks to go. Next one's Shootaboo. Oh my god, it could be like Gangster Boo by Ice Spice. That would be perfect. Come on. Get in your bag, Mabu.
I got a Glock for my little boo to keep it in her shoe. When I slide, she come for the rock. Gripping on my 2, throw 29. She throwing a few, we throw 32. If I'm shooting, then she shooting too. That's just how we move.
Find me a person who can relate to the song. Find me a person. Please. She might shoot a boo, she might shoot a boo. She might shoot at you, she might shoot at you. She might shoot a boo, she might shoot a boo. Yeah, one wrong move, she might shoot you too. Yeah, back to the crib, I'm wandering. I'm sorry, man, but I'm gonna use this word loosely. Anybody who can relate to this song specifically has to be under the age of 14. There's no fucking way. When I'm breaking up a spot, I could have seen it. I'm like, who, me? Excuse me, call me Tom Cruise or Bruce Lee. Glock for my little boots to keep it in her shoe. When I slide, she come for the rock, gripping on my two throat. She might shoot a boo, she might shoot a boo. Yeah, one wrong move, she might shoot you too. Shoot a boo, shoot a boo. Shoot at you, shoot at you. Shoot a boo, shoot a boo. One wrong move, she might shoot you too. Yeah, Mabu sounded like a Pokemon on that song, just singing his battle cry to you over and over and over. I don't rock with that song one bit. That song is terrible. More power to you if you can relate to that song in some way, but I'm not seeing it. I don't see the vision. Let's keep it moving.
My God, gotta get healthier this year.
Meeks. Happy New Year.
New year, new me, new clothes. Get to the bag and double the hoes.
Get away from the hate and the cold. Small circle like the nuts with the dog.
Screw all the cons and look at the post. Stop popping perks, it's making you slow. Bad vibes, leave them right at the door. Ha, you know how I roll. Get money, get hoes. Get money, get hoes. Get money, get hoes. Repeat and do it again. Bet.
Fuck, there could not be a better sense of irony right there. Get money, get hoes. Get money. Get hoes, get money, get hoes, repeat and do it again. Sounds like the last, what, 12 tracks of this album?
Get hoes, get money, get hoes, get money.
Kano's funny, my little snow bunny. My love language is money and she can talk to me. Repeat and do it again.
Get money, get hoes, get money, get hoes.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie, that wasn't probably the most sensitive use of another language in a song. Gonna keep it at that and keep it moving. Let's get into Rich Scholar. Great.
I'm a rich scholar, got the city shook. I make top dollar like a white collar crook.
How could I? There's a video for it. And there's another video that I didn't even have pulled up. So we're getting video season here. Let's go.
As a large gathering of angry motherfuckers
have assembled. Let's fucking go, baby!
Young rapper, Little Mabu, versus his educational prowess. And you, miss, why are you here this morning?
I can't believe I sympathize with the Karens. Ah! I'm old. Ah!
Things have to change.
Things have to change. Think about the children.
Little Mabu is a bad influence.
He's a bad influence. Look at him. He fucking hitting his. He hitting his shit. We gotta get him out of the schools. He's hitting it too hard.
I'm a rich scholar, got the city shook. I make top dollar like a white collar crook. Keep a white collar, black forces on my foot.
Envy people who envy you can't keep them close. They might give a quote to the post. You know how that could go.
It's TikTok.
The post cabin.
We start
doing Greek and Latin. Several mothers at my school hate me with a passion. They want their son in school with a kid rapping. Like, she give me walkie top, periodic shoddy, hot tamale, give me walkie top. Hold on. Periodic means she curvy though. I could be tangent to your curve, but you ain't worthy, ho, cause I'm a rich scholar.
That's one. That's one. I'll acknowledge when there's one.
Got the city shook. I make top dollar like a white collar crook. Keep a white collar, black forces on my foot. And I stick with my brothers like the pages of a.
You know, I'm gonna throw a little side tangent in here cause he wants to bring up tangents. I would love to see Lil Mabu get in a rap battle. But no, not like a little on the street corner rap battle. I want a big stage, 3-round written performance rap battle against the big, the mighty 6-foot-plus New Jersey twerk. And I want to see how he comes out of that. If anybody can make that happen, I will pay the money to watch it. Please. Please get this guy on a stage with an actual battle rapper.
Don't judge a book by its cover like these mothers do. Can't say their names because I get fucking sued. What did I do?
Yeah, leave the kids alone, man. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I found the video to be a little bit fun to play around with, and the song not to be that terrible. There's a little bit of a charm to it. If any song has worked the most right now, it would probably be this one. And a lot of that is contributed to the fact that I ain't gonna be caught dead supporting Karens. That ain't fucking happening here. Let's move it into the next one, keep it rolling. Yeah, I'm already familiar with this song, and this one is a big pile of dog shit, but let's just listen to it again. Like I said, leave the fucking kids alone, dude. Make your own shitty music, but once you start getting the kids involved with it, now I'm like, why are you doing that?
Mabu?
Mabu?
Don't in my hood.
How much the water?
$1.
I like your hustle. Forget the water though, hop in.
Really?
Let me get you some real drip. You're a big dog now.
Big dog now. How you close the door?
Fucking Blues Clues on there.
I'm a big dog. I do big dog shit. I fuck your bitch wrong. I heard she been wanting a kid.
I'm a big dog and I do big dog shit. And that big body whoop like it's Paw Patrol, bitch.
Who let the dogs out?
There's a chance the kid made the lyrics himself. But even then, what are you doing, like, bigging that up? And even worse, if Mabu wrote the lyrics for the kid and just kind of pushed him to record him, what the fuck are you doing? You're the adult in this situation. I know he's barely a fucking adult, but, like, you are the adult in this situation. Grow the fuck up. Stop getting kids to act like bad kids. Good job. I can't wait to see the generations of people that want to grow up and emulate this, too.
Who let the dogs outside? A stand for aim.
B stand for boom.
C cause I'm a crip.
And yeah, we're not doing that shit. I'm sorry, I've completely forgot he even did that shit here. We're not doing that. If anybody is aware, you know how stupid of a fucking thing that was right there. You're a fucking dumbass. Stop doing that shit. Don't fucking defend the guy either, because you probably don't know what the fuck he just did there and why it was so significant. Fuck you. That's what I gotta say after that.
He's definitely-
his ass a lollipop when he do good.
Let me contribute.
Thanks, Ortiz. You know what? Here's a lollipop.
What the hell is this? Ain't no baby. You send this to Dennis?
Watch your mouth, huh?
How many lips do it take?
Lollipop.
How many hits in a year has the marble dropped?
I don't even know. Big bro, let go spin his block.
Who let the dogs outside?
Yo, little bro, say what you gotta say.
I know a lot of people got stuff to say about me. I'm just a kid from Atlanta. Just how I grew up. Mabu told me 100 times.
It's deeper than music.
I'm a big dog, I do big dog shit. I fuck your bitch raw. I heard she been wanting the kid. I'm a big dog, I do big dog shit.
In a big body whip, like it's Paw Patrol, bitch.
Who let the dogs out?
You know, not that the vocals were anything really redeemable at the beginning. They really kind of just fell off a cliff at this back end with those kind of like deeper tones and now like the higher pitched ones. It's just kind of all over the place. Yeah, my main takeaway after this song is I really forgot how much I hated it when I first heard it. And I don't just hate it to hate it. I actually do think that this song is a bit problematic. Take it or leave it. You're free to disagree with me here, but remember when Lil Tay was running her tirade on Instagram? Everyone was so concerned. Who's making her say all this stuff? Who's behind the scenes controlling this? And everyone got in a big tizzy about it, but no one seems to give a fuck here. And I know the little RT kid had his little second to say his piece about being from Atlanta, and it's just how it is. But the kid's young, dude. You don't need to be pushing him right into this kind of light. That's my take. Your take may be different. I just find the song very insensitive. That's it. Only 2 more songs to get through, so let's just get this thing over with and then I'll give my final thoughts here.
You know, I'm turning over a new leaf. And I know they looking down from the sky. From the sky. And they wondering why they mans ain't never slide.
Defend the singing.
So fake. I'm tired of getting played.
Oh,
I just need a switch.
Fuck no. What? Are you fucking kidding? No. There's no fucking way. There is actually no fucking way. I am hearing what I'm hearing right now. Oh my fucking god. This is the worst piece of dog shit I've ever heard.
Make the ops run. Put the hands up when I play the my drum. Hit the dog before I turn you to lunch.
I'm not listening to this.
Meaning is the time of the month. Let's have some fun. You better not run.
Fine. I'll keep listening.
Oh my god!
Oh my god. Wow. Yeah, I honestly can't believe what I just listened to. I thought of all things, you know, we were just going to have a smooth release here, 2 songs. They were going to be as uninteresting as everything else here. That song was interesting for all the wrong reasons. What the hell was that cover? What the absolute hell was he doing there? I'm torn between, like, thinking either he thought that was the coolest thing he's done on this project and it really deserved to be here, in which case, like, shame on you, that was horrible. Or he thought it was the funniest thing ever and he should include it here, in which case I'm almost inclined to give it a 100, because as far as bad music goes, this is up there on that list. I cannot express enough how, like, off-putting that song is. Final song is At What Cost.
Say no more, all good things end. We all heard that one before. Whoever said that shit better prepare for a war. Cause I'm good, I'll pass it on to generations and more.
I lost my brothers to this shit. Look to the sky and I salute. I look my brother in his eyes. I almost cried, I miss you too, honey.
Yeah.
it, but at what cost? Should I have spent time with friends instead of being a boss? Should I have put down the mic and maybe take up lacrosse? I've been trying to find my...
You know, I think that line really encapsulates a lot of what I'm not liking about this project, is that most of the subject matter here is extremely heavy and serious stuff. And on the final closing track, you know, Mabu is facing all his challenges and poor decisions in life, and he says, oh, should I hung out with my friends more? Or was it, you know, worth the cost? Yada, yada, yada. And it's just like, that feels genuine right there. That statement of him saying, was it worth working on my music instead of hanging out with my friends? That is the most genuine thing we've gotten here. And hearing it at the very end makes everything before it sound like a giant pile of bullshit. Fake bullshit. If you like this music, I'm not gonna fool myself and pretend you've made it this far anyway. You're already leaving your comment calling me a fucking dumbass for hating on this. But I challenge you, if you are hearing me say this, tell me what you like about this. Tell me what you think is worthwhile here, and tell me why you think that this is music that deserves to be praised. If you think this is really some of the best stuff you've ever heard, explain to me why you think this deserves my praise, because I have nothing really good to say about this. I'd love to have great things to say about it, but as it stands, this is not worth complimenting. This is dog shit.
Myself at all. I love my fam, but it's not showing at all. I ain't been playing catch with pops or chasing after a ball. Oh God. I just smile and shake their hand. It's kind of funny, man. I always knew my biggest haters would be my biggest fans.
Oh my God, he's talking to me! I am the biggest Mabu fan. I love Mabu. Jesus fucking Christ, he is so full of himself. I ain't even sorry, dude. After watching that video and that song, dude, he really truly thinks he is bigger than the fucking world itself, and that he is on top of everybody else. So we listened to it. Young genius. It's done. Final thoughts on the record. I think this is actually a giant pile of offensive dog crap. If you think differently, great. Cool. Like I said before, let me know down below why you like this project, and actually tell me reasons that you enjoy the project. But I don't find anything really redeemable here. It seems to be poking light and taking the easy opportunity to get clicks by, you know, being very attention grabbing. Ooh, white guy in the hood. So interesting, right? And you want to click it. And then you go, oh, he can actually flow a little bit. It's kind of impressive. But you're giving him way too many bonus points. That's my opinion, but I did not like a single thing I was hearing here. Even the moments where I was kind of holding back my criticism, it was not enjoyment. This was just finding some kind of redeemable elements here. With that being said, the best thing about this project, it's clearly the instrumentals. Some of them are hard-hitting, and honestly, they should have went to other artists. This project's biggest offense to me is taking itself too seriously, in that it presents a lot of heavy subject matter in a way that I think makes light of the situation, and it doesn't actually provide any nuance or context to it. It really is just jumping on a trend and doing the suburban white kid does drill rap thing. And I don't care if Mabu is from New York or this or that. Do I have to paint it out for you? Highlight moment on the record was definitely the second to last track here, Oppie Day. Not a highlight for a good reason, though. Highlight for a terrible reason. He should have never covered that song. It was funny to listen to, though. It at least gave me one laugh on the entire project. Overall, I'm feeling like a 7 out of 100 on this project. Yeah, it's really bad. Don't listen to this. If you made it this far, Alvin, don't send me Mabu anymore, please. I don't think my brain can handle it. With that being said, it's been Jake. It's been fun. But take care, guys. Good night. Love.